This is the second part for the quick revision guide for fluid mechanics. In this, I have covered the fluid kinematics and fluid dynamics. It is the study of fluid with the consideration of motion, but without the cause of motion. So in this, we do not consider the cause of motion, that is force. We consider only the motion, that is the velocity and acceleration. So in fluid kinematics, that is an important term, streamline. Streamline is defined as the imaginary line drawn in a flow field such that a tangent drawn at any point represents the direction of velocity vector at that point. And this equation of this streamline is dx by u. U is the velocity in x direction, must be equals to dy divided by v. V is the velocity in y direction, equals to dz divided by w. W is the velocity in z direction. Then very important equation, continuity equation, the basic governing equation of fluid mechanics, continuity equation, that is conservation of mass. It is rho 1 a1 v1 is equals to rho 2 a2 v2 if the flow is compressible. But if the fluid is incompressible, then this rho 1 will become equals to rho 2 and a1 v1 is equals to a2 and v2. This a1 and v1 is known as discharge also. So discharge is area into velocity from the continuity equation. Now this continuity equation can also be derived in the three dimensions. So in three dimensions, the general continuity equation will be d rho by dt plus del by del x into rho u plus del by del y rho v plus del by del z rho into w is equals to zero. If the flow is incompressible, then this rho will become constant. And again, if the flow is steady, then the change in property with respect to time will become zero. So del rho by del t will be equal to zero, and density will become constant for the incompressible fluid. And this general continuity equation converts into the form del u by del x plus del v by del y plus del w by del z is equals to zero. Of fluid, and the acceleration of fluid in the x direction can be defined as ax is equals to u del u by del x plus v del u by del y plus w del u by del z plus del u by del t. In this, the component with respect to space, that is del x, del y, del z, are known as convective acceleration, whereas the differentiation with respect to time is known as local acceleration or the temporal acceleration. If the flow type is steady and uniform, so for the uniform flow, change in property with respect to space will be zero. So convective acceleration is zero and flow is steady, then the change in property with respect to time zero, then the temporal acceleration is zero. So for a steady and uniform flow, total acceleration is zero. Now similarly for the steady and non-uniform, so convective acceleration will exist, but the temporal acceleration will be zero. If the flow is unsteady and uniform, then the convective acceleration will be zero, but the temporal acceleration will exist. If the flow is unsteady and non-uniform, then these both acceleration will exist. Component. So rotational component can be derived by this formula, omega is equals to 1 by 2 ijk this determinant, and omega x is the rotational component in x direction. It is 1 by 2 del w by del y minus del v by del z. Similarly, we can derive it also for y direction and z direction. If the flow is irrotational, then the value of these rotational components must be zero. So omega x, omega y and omega z all are zero for the irrotational flow. So vorticity is twice of omega. Then circulation is vorticity multiplied by area. Now the velocity potential function. So velocity it is another important topic in the fluid kinematics. So in general, this function is defined in 3D flow as a function of shape and time, such that the negative derivative of this function with respect to space directly gives velocity in that direction. So suppose the negative derivation of this function with respect to x gives the velocity in that direction, means u. Similarly, if the derivation with respect to y, then we get the velocity v. With respect to z, we will get w. So it satisfies the Laplace equation del square phi by del x square plus del phi square plus del y square is equals to 0. And if velocity potential exists, then the flow must be irrotational. So it exists only in irrotational flow. Similarly, stream function is denoted by psi, then its derivation with respect to direction gives the velocity in the perpendicular direction. So derivation with respect to x give the velocity in v in the y direction. Similarly, derivation with y gives the velocity in x direction, that is u. So the psi can exist in both rotational as well as in irrotational. Similarly, we can also derive the value of discharge with the help of this psi. So the difference in the stream function gives the discharge per unit. Dynamics, it is the study of motion of fluid with the consideration of cause of motion, that is force. So with the consideration of force, study is known as fluid dynamics. So in fluid dynamics, the very important equation is Bernoulli's equation, that is P upon rho g plus v square upon 2g plus z is equals to constant. In this, P upon rho g is pressure head, v square upon 2g is kinetic head, and z is datum head. Now these are the basic governing equations, that is Navier-Stokes equation. If the flow is laminar and irrotational, then the momentum equation derived is known as Navier-Stokes equation. Now if I add one more assumption, that is flow is in viscosity, then this momentum equation will become Euler's equation. And if I add two more assumptions, that is the steady flow and the compressible flow, and I integrate this equation, then this becomes Bernoulli's equation, and it is also known as energy equation. So total energy always remains constant. In this Bernoulli equation, the energy is in form of head. So head form of energy is there. This P upon rho g plus z is known as piezometric head, and this piezometric head is very helpful to determine the flow through various devices. Bernoulli's principle is venturi meter, and from the Bernoulli's equation we can derive it very simply. V2 square minus V1 square divided by 2G is equals to P1 upon rho G plus Z1 minus P2 upon rho G plus Z2. This difference is known as H, that is differential head of venturi meter, and we can easily derive this discharge. Q is equals to A1 A2 under root 2gh divided by a1 square minus a2 square. A1 is the pipe diameter, a2 is the throat diameter. This mass flow rate also we can derive. For the mass flow rate, this discharge is simply multiplied by the rho. The value of this coefficient of discharge 0.97 to 0.99. This coefficient of discharge is multiplied with the theoretical discharge to get the actual discharge. Now the venturi meter is equipped with the manometer. So in place of piezometer, if a manometer is used, then this value of H will become X rho m by rho minus 1. Now, if an inverted U-tube manometer is there, then this H will become X multiplied by 1 minus rho m by rho. For the venturi meter, this diameter must be equals to D1 by 3 or D1 by 2, the half of the pipe diameter. And the angle of convergence must be 21 degree to 25 degree, and the angle of divergence will be 5 degree to 7 degree, because the angle of divergence, the divergence part is more than the convergent part. Now the orifice meter. So orifice meter is the another application of the Bernoulli's principle. It is a simple plate with a hole at the center and can be inserted in a pipe to determine the flow through the pipe. So the formula will be Q is equals to CD A1 A2 under root 2GH divided by A1 square minus A2 square, where A2 is the orifice area and A1 is the pipe area. In this case, the coefficient of discharge is less than the venturi meter, that is 0.62 to 0.69. Now it is simply orifice. So simply orifice, it is this simple opening in a tank is known as orifice. And this theoretical velocity through this orifice can be determined as under root 2gh. So through this velocity, we can calculate the actual velocity by multiplying it by the coefficient of velocity, and through that we can calculate the discharge. The another important application is pitot tube. Pitot tube can be used for determine the velocity at a point inside a flow. This is a L-shaped tube, and the formula to calculate the velocity is V is equals to CV under root 2GH. It can be defined with the help of Bernoulli's principle. So from the Bernoulli's equation, it can be derived the P2 upon rho g plus z2 minus P1 upon rho g plus z1. Similarly, the head, P geometric head, or the differential head of this pitot tube. If the P in the place of P geometer, manometer is used, then this H will become X rho m by rho minus 1. And if the inverted U tube manometer is there, then H is equals to X 1 minus rho m by rho.